Now I invite our second speaker, Mr. Ashish Anand. He'll be talking on rural development and CSR, a corporate perspective.
Good afternoon once again. So it was really a nice pleasure standing here and facing you people. Let me first thank the entire JIDA's administration management who has called me here for this 15-20 minutes sort of presentation. I have penned on a couple of these slides for this audience. I know that my previous speakers have done a lot of hard work and they have presented a very beautiful arena as far as the rural development is concerned. So we'll start with the topic that is rural development and CSR. There are a couple of pictures which is quite, I think, glowing. But again, we all know that why rural development is required, but I will show you a different picture. I will try to show you a different picture. So one side we have India shining. You can see the photographs where we have all luxuries of life, people living in cities. But at the other side, there are Bharat struggling. And I think that is the reason why I'm standing here and why you people are listening to me, and that is the reason why rural development is required. So we cannot have two faces of a nation, two heads at different stages of development. So that is why I have tried to bring a different perspective of rural India, which is again a coin sort of thing, which is rich in mineral, rich in natural beauty, bounty, rainfall, fertile land, forest cover, rich in human capital. But at the other side, it is already been discussed, we are at the bottom of the development cycle. Each day we are losing opportunities, whether it is from rural areas to cities or from cities to America and US and other countries. So each day we are losing opportunities as far as the human power, manpower is concerned. Poor infrastructure leading to large scale migration, which has been talked by the earlier presenter. So my statement is, and my concern is, we cannot live in an island of affluence surrounded by a sea of poverty. And that is why we require a development perspective, a rural development perspective. But again, at the same time, I would like to ask question from this house, that last 60 years or 67 years, lot of money has been pumped in rural India. Lot of money has been pumped by CSR, whether it is called CSR or government or NGOs or individual like Dr. Sahab. We have pumped lot of money, but then why we need still development in rural areas? Have we not able to crack the nut? Hum paise kharch karte chale gaye. Have you touched the nerves? Ki where we really require to pump money? I think that's a $1 million question we need to ask ourselves. Ki whether we have achieved or where we have succeeded to touch the nerve where the money has to go. I think that's a $1 million question. That's why I have figured on this slide. Do we have a national solution? We have different player, individual, we have government, corporate, civil society organization, and everybody is trying to pull the rural India up. But still, I think this is a question I have given to you people to think upon. Initially, when we talk about CSR, two, three things come into our mind. First, there are huge money with corporate. They can do anything. I believe so. It is one of the question coming to everybody's mind. And to an extent is true also that the corporate starts CSR looking as quick fix reaction, doling out something, philanthropy, not exactly philanthropy, lekin aaj hand pump chahiye, do hand pump. Tomorrow someone is asking ambulance, give it ambulance in the name of CSR. Day after tomorrow someone is asking blanket, give it blanket. I think that is a quick fix reaction. It has result, very limited result. So a potential mindset within the community, dependence, sycophancy, favoritism. And the last line which I have written, I think it is applicable to each one of us, the corporates, which has seen CSR as a quick fix reaction, that danger of becoming 24/7 Santa Claus. Tuck, tuck. Sir, I need an ambulance. So ambulance chala gaya. So I think this is not CSR exactly. And that is why, sir, when you are asking, there are a lot of money being pumped and result is not coming. I think this is one of the reason why the result is not there. People have seen CSR as a 24/7 Santa Claus. So my point of view is, development is a warm-up marathon. Silo-type project-based activities leave little impact, and I think these all, you all will agree with this, and you all have experience in this also. JIDAS, whether it's JIDAS or ASA or some, or any organization, they very well understand that this silo-type projects have no, either no effect or very little effect. And community development is a proactive marathon, not a quick fix reactive sprint. It's not a 100 meter race. You start and you complete, final, finish. It's a long marathon, which needs a long term planning, as said by Dinesh Agarwal sir, which needs a clear indicator also. And that is how marathon is being run by the Dhawaks. So we need to be very clear whether we want to be quick fix or marathon. So there is no room for maybe, because in some of the cases people are in double standard. Ye bhi ho sakta hai, wo bhi ho sakta hai. It is not maybe. I think it's a marathon race, and the money which you are pumping into the society, that has to be clear mindset. It is a marathon race. It has to be spent for 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, and that's how the result will come. I will relate my whole these 4-5 slides with some of my experiences in field in Jharkhand, where I've worked for 10 years, and Madhya Pradesh, where I've been working for last 3 years and so. So we had 3-4 models when we were working in Jharkhand, sir. One model was called TVM, Total Village Management, and it is derived from TPM, Total Productivity Maintenance. I think the industry people will understand the TPM thing. So it is a Japanese word, TPM, Total Productivity Maintenance. From that the term come TVM, Total Village Management. So in TPM, what we industry people do, basically we tap leakage to maximize the output. So in TVM also, we try to do the same thing, planning at grassroots and so and so forth, so and so on. And you can see the result of some of the data, and these data are verified by some agency. I will show that in the name of the agency. You see, in 2011, we have started with 15 farmers, and the average productivity of paddy, which is a staple crop in this part of country, and people basically it is in the food habit. So 9 quintal per acre, and if you compare it with India, it's still the highest productivity in the state like Punjab and all is 23-24 quintal per acre. In your state, that is in Madhya Pradesh, is 4.5 quintal per acre, and in the district from where I am coming, it is 2.3 quintal per acre. The data from where this data has came. So 2011, there were 15 farmers with average productivity of 9 quintal per acre, and in 14 last year, it was 1054 farmer with 23.5 quintal per acre. You can see the difference, and the difference came because we were very clear in our mind that it is not a 100 meter race, it is not a quick fix, it's not a doling out. It's not something they do dekhing result kya hoga. It was planned and well executed with a para professionals. The professional like us, not the para professionals, means the villagers, the gram mitras, those who are engaged in the whole program, and you can see the result. The second graph again, this was the wheat and this is the paddy, the wheat. So you cannot say it's a silo type project ki paddy mein kya ho gaya. It's a full 1 year project, 1 year program, where we try to increase the productivity of farm produce so that the round the year food security can be secured at one individual farmer level. That is the primary level. You can see the another data which I have already stated. The state average of Madhya Pradesh is 5.6 acre per quintal per acre. The district where I am coming from, Anuppur, is 3.5 quintal per acre. And you can see, sir, and other students also, in HPPL command area, that is Hindustan Power Project command area, it is 23.5 quintal per acre. Almost we are competing with the states like Punjab and Haryana, where they have everything plus money, lakhs of money pumped only for agriculture productivity enhancement. You can see this. I'm showing you because I personally feel that the area we are walking, the topic which I have chosen, rural development, is a very, 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 very tedious thing to understand if you are not planning at grassroot. If the people of villages are not engaged, they are not consulted from the time, beginning time, I think it is a very, very important thing for any CSR sort of thing. Even in wheat you can see, and source I have written, you can check it if you want. I have couple of videos also, clips also. But before going to video clip, I would like to point out some two, three more things. We have heard about PPP. Sir, I think PPP is a common word, public-private partnership. But for whom this PPP is? I think it is for people. So I think this P3 should be replaced by P4, public, people, private partnership. Otherwise, if you miss out people, then for whom this partnership all about? So I think this is one of the core area which needs again revisiting for the people like us, corporate. Us means corporate. The people like civil society, NGOs, like individual, Dr. Sahab, or the government. It all needs a rethink that the PPP, which is planned for people, people is missing. So you need to restructure the whole thing. I think P3 should be replaced by P4. One is this. Second, in corporate, we used to mention one line. Sir, I think you would agree with me. The business of business is business. The business of business, I agree that even CSR has a clear business motive in that. But at the same time, if we are clear, yes, our society within, our society outside our factories or outside our this plant, if they are underprivileged or if they are not developed, the factory cannot live in an isolation. So I think again the CSR under CSR perspective, it is very important to know if where we are working and how we are working and where we want to reach at the same time. So these are two things. And third, which is again I learned when I was doing my MSW in Jamia, there was a professor Siddiqui who used to give us an example, sir. He in 80s there was a program from government, family planning program, and I'm sure that you must be remembering Sanjay Gandhi, late Sanjay Gandhi, who forced all these things. So people were forced to jail, people were forced to hospitals, forcibly they were vasectomy, tubectomy was done. What is the result? I think the result was horrible. It was failed miserably. Coming to 2013, 14, 15, 16, there is no Sanjay Gandhi. Nobody is forcing you, neither me. There is no force from government, there is no act as such. But people are going to hospital. They are asking, they are demanding. Not even in urban area, but rural area also, they are demanding. Why this is coming? Why this is a change in mindset? I believe that there is a word called felt need. There is a need and there is a felt need. Need is everywhere, I think. In 80s, it was a need of the nation to control the birth. It was not the need of the poor people who believed that 4 hands, 6 hands, 8 hands can generate more revenue for their family. Now, the resources have shrunk down. There is less resources. People felt that now the farmland is shrunk. We have less number of people working in farmland. As sir told that the young people is not willing to work in the field. So they know that now if they have more number of say children, youth or children coming in the family, it is hard to sustain the family. So that time's need is today's that individual farmers or individual persons felt need. So that has to be recognized and that has to be identified by the people across society, whether it is CSR, professional, NGO professional, individual or anybody. That has to be recognized. So three things very important. First, P3 to be changed in my mind, it is my opinion, personal opinion, P3 to be changed to P4. Second, again the business of business is business, but what business? That has to be cleared. Again, as a CSR point of view, it has to be very, very clarified where you want to go, how you want to go, what is its status. And third, very importantly, that need has to be converted into felt need. And that is only possible when you sit with the villagers. When you merge your identity with the villagers' identity, and then only it can be changed from a need to felt need. I will show you three clips, very small clips, some 50 second, 30 seconds clips. You can ask me that these clips are being covered by you, so you can cover anything. But believe me, honestly, these clips are not covered by me, it is somebody else. Hope it will run.
कि पानी नहीं गिरता तब क्या करें यहाँ काम धाम है ना, तो आप देहात के आदमी सोचता है कि क्या बताएं क्या खाएंगे, कमी हो जाए घर में। इसके बाद मैं भाग गया उड़ीसा, उड़ीसा गया, फिर उसके एक दो साल उधर फिर रहा, फिर अगले साल ऐसे मतलब मेरे को पता चला कि इस बारे में मतलब गेहूं का बीज मिलता है, चना, फिर आया वहाँ से तो देखा कि मतलब इतने इतने किसान हमारे से जो पीछे के किसान है इतने मतलब कि उन लोग हमारे से परसेंट आगे जा रहा है। अगले साल से जब इसमें मैं मतलब आने जाने लगा तब से मेरे को पता चला कि नहीं इसमें आज साथ में रहने